My name is David Pazmino.
David Pazmino.
David Pazmino.
Today is May 21st, 2021.
May 21st, 2022.
May 21st, 2023.
I am 15 years old.
I'm 16 years old. About to be 17 in like 9 days, so.
I'm 17 years old.
At the time of this recording, I have 20,980 subscribers.
21,958 subscribers.
22,175 subscribers.
1,353 Instagram followers.
1,480 followers.
1,530 followers, I believe. This year was really, really crazy for me getting noticed. Like, compared to my freshman and junior year, I got noticed here and there, but in my senior year, I got noticed so many times, and this is crazy because this was literally random people that I don't even know. Once the word gets out in your high school, everyone knows. Not really that, but besides high school, I got noticed one time when I went to Guitar Center.
At the moment, let me check what I've been listening to. I've been listening a lot to Tickets to My Downfall by Machine Gun Kelly, his new album. Probably if I had to pick one from that album, Bloody Valentine is my favorite song at the moment. Probably Make Up Sex by Machine Gun Kelly. I love Machine Gun Kelly, dude.
My favorite song at the moment it's called Fake Plastic Trees by Radiohead. I've been really getting into Radiohead lately. It's so good.
I don't really watch movies, but probably like Guardians of the Galaxy 2, because the ending was just beautiful with father and son. I loved it so much. There's this movie called Soul. It's so good. Like, it teaches you all about life and like a life lesson. And I would really, really recommend watching it.
My favorite movie, I literally watched it like two days ago. It's Guardians of the Galaxy 3. That movie was so good, man. I'm not gonna say much, but that movie had me crying, smiling, laughing, wheezing, all the emotions. That movie was so good.
I don't really watch movies, but probably like Guardians of the Galaxy.
Oh, you see that?
The ending was beautiful with father and son. I loved it so much. Yeah, One by Metallica, Everything. That's definitely the hardest song. It took me the longest to learn.
Lonesome Town by Ricky Nelson, probably. It's a fingerstyle version. It's really hard fingerstyle because you have to slap and pick at the same time, but also doing weird things with your left hand.
Honestly, probably Kill Me Girl. Kill Me Girl by the Backseat Lovers. I just put out a band cover for that song on my YouTube channel if you wanna check it out.
Not yet. I can't do a kickflip yet. I have landed a kickflip though. I've landed a kickflip of total of like 4 times. When I land it, I just forget how to do it. But hopefully in a year, I'm able to land a kickflip, but as of now, I cannot.
Oh man, I knew this question was coming. No, I can't do a kickflip. I know. If you guys watch my old videos, I used to skateboard a lot. Now, I don't really skateboard. I just use it for transportation. Flip tricks, I'm just not built for them. I don't even skate anymore, bro. I literally just use it for transportation. Like in the city or to school.
Oh my god. I knew this question was coming, bro. I can't. Long story short, I can't. And I don't think I will be able to for a long time because I don't skate. My freshman year was when I was really into skating. I could do a kickflip then, but I don't skate anymore. I just use it for transportation. Personal questions now?
Yeah, personal questions.
Okay.
Do you ever feel stressed?
No, honestly, I don't. Like, I honestly don't think I've ever felt stressed in my life. It's just something weird about me. Like, no matter how much work I have, I'm always able to do it if it's work that I like, and I always find time to do it because I know it's work that needs to be done. But like, whenever I have a bunch of work, I just do it. I never really felt stressed in my life. Obviously, like, I get upset when there's a lot of work, but I'm not like thinking about it. I don't let it ruin my day, and you shouldn't.
I don't feel right now that I have stress. I feel like it's more that like I'm stuck. Like, I'm doing so many things. Like, I'm playing guitar, I'm still learning guitar, I'm still learning piano, I'm making YouTube videos, and I'm trying out for my high school soccer team. Like, so many things that I need, that I hope that they go well, especially YouTube. Like, I really want YouTube to go well, and I feel like that is stressing me, because I'm focusing on so many topics.
I kind of alluded at the same thing. Like, I don't really feel stressed. I guess stuck is more the perfect word. Like, even though I do all this work, I'm expecting like the best outcome, and then when I don't get it, I feel stuck. I guess that makes me feel stressed a little, but I don't really feel stressed. That's a good question. What is going on in the world right now? Well, coronavirus officially ended, like, I think 2 weeks ago. The FDA, or the World Health Organization, announced that coronavirus, the pandemic, is done. Like, it's no longer a pandemic. It's no longer, like, that serious, which is great. It took, like, 3 years for that to end. Besides that, I don't think anything else major is happening in the world.
Two things. Coronavirus is still a thing, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, it was there before. Supposedly, it's getting worse. That's what they say every time.
Besides that, in global news, there is a war between Russia and Ukraine.
Oh, which is not
good at all. Basically, Russia is trying to take part of Ukraine. People are saying that could lead to World War III. So, it's kind of scary. Just a little scary, you know?
Forgot's not a good word for that, but yeah, the war between Russia and Ukraine is still going on. No. I have never been depressed in my life. Thank God, I'm very grateful for that. I've never been, at least to what I know the definition of depressed is, I never felt like really, really sad or like there was like a lot going on for me. I never felt depressed. There's been a lot of like hardships this year, but I never let it get the best of me. I always push through, and I never felt depressed. I'm very grateful for that.
Same way, I don't think I've ever been depressed in my life. I remember there was a point last year where I felt like during quarantine where I didn't have many friends because school was online, I couldn't make friends. This year's was a lot better. I met a lot of new friends and a lot of new people, and I feel a lot more better, and I don't think I've ever been depressed in my life.
Same thing as last year, I never really felt depressed. I don't think so. I never let my emotions get the best of me. Everything that I went through, I felt like I handled it great, and yeah, I never felt depressed. Hopefully that continues on to next year. No, I don't. I know my dreams, I know my goal, I know my career path, and it's to do with whatever I want to do, which is, right now, it's YouTube, and I know it may not seem like it because I don't really upload, but it's just that I'm in my senior year of high school right now, and so much is going on, I'm so busy right now, but as soon as the summer comes, I'm going to be on that grind, because that's the only thing I'm gonna focus on. There has been some points, yeah, when like I uploaded a video and I thought it was great and then I barely got any views. And yeah, like I guess in the moment, not really giving up, but I felt that and disappointed. I felt disappointed, but I know like I have what it takes to succeed in this. And whenever like I do something and it fails, I just get up and try it again.
I had this one point with YouTube. I don't know when exactly, but there was a point where I was uploading and I had fun uploading the videos and editing them, and they weren't getting views. And it really hurt me because like I was putting my all, and I thought the videos were good, but they weren't getting views. And that, then I felt like giving up. But I stuck through that, and I'm in the same like stage right now. But I know that it'll all be worth it because I love doing this and I'll never give up. If I just keep doing it, if I stay consistent and put my all into it, I know it'll all work out.
I could not agree with myself more than what I said last year. Yeah, just keep doing it. That's it. Even though you guys saw, I didn't really make that much progress in terms of subscribers. In terms of other terms, we'll probably get onto that later. I did improve with a lot of stuff. We'll probably get onto that later. I said this in my last video I uploaded, so go check that out. My biggest regret is not joining the soccer team my freshman year for high school. That's it. It was a mistake. I was stupid. I don't know why I didn't join, and I really, really, really regret that.
My biggest regret is posting certain feelings on social media. Don't post your feelings on social media. It won't do any good. Keep them to yourself.
I learned a lot from last year. I'm still kind of big on that, not as much as I was at that time, because that time I was going through something. I'm still like, I don't really post much of my, I guess, feelings on social media. That's just me, obviously. Everyone has their own takes on it. It's just that I guess I have more of a public like following. Like some things I want to keep to myself. I don't know. I wish I should have joined soccer team. In 1 year, let's get this right, because I've gotten this wrong, I'm pretty sure, the other years. In 1 year, I'm going to be in college. I will be 18 years old, turning 19. I better have, I'm just gonna say this, a lot more money than I have right now. That is a big goal of mine, to just be more stable. Not even be rich, like I don't really care about that. Just stable enough to provide for myself. And in order to provide for my YouTube and like my own stuff, I feel like the last year I have gained, not even the last year, the last couple months, I have gained so much more knowledge on the space that I'm trying to grow with YouTube. I feel like these past 3 years, there has not been a growth in subscribers. There just hasn't. I feel like there has to be a growth within the next year. And if there isn't, I'm gonna say it right now, if there isn't, there's something wrong. There's something wrong, and I'm so disappointed in you, because I've really learned so much, and I feel like I have what it takes. I know I have what it takes, because I uploaded a video on YouTube like I think 5 months ago, and it has like 15,000 views, and that has been my most viewed video in a while. It's not like I haven't grown at all with social media. I started posting onto TikTok. One of my videos got over 10 million views on TikTok. Another video got 5 million views, and another video got 1 million views, and I have like over 2 million likes on it on my TikTok account. That is a, whenever I feel down, that is a constant reminder to me that I have what it takes. I have what it takes to make good content that people watch. Because, bro, it got 10 million views. Like, not that many people can say that. Whenever I'm feeling down, I literally open my TikTok and I look at that. In 1 year, there has to be a significant amount of growth with my social media. There just has to.
Where do I see myself in 1 year now? I'm gonna be a senior. I'll probably, I think I'll know which college I'm going to.
Queens College.
Maybe I'm not going to college, I don't know, but hopefully this YouTube thing works. But hopefully you're a lot better at guitar too. Prediction? Okay.
It got worse.
Let's be honest. 50,000 subs. 50,000 subs, come on. Yeah, I'm only like 25. I'm only like 30,000 more.
Damn, okay, let's go through the step by step. I'm better at guitar in some ways. I definitely did not improve as much as I should have, but I don't learn as much as I should. I'm a senior now, going to college. I'm not going. That dream is done. 50,000 subscribers. I remember back then when I said that, I thought it was a good number. If I'm gonna make a prediction for next year, let's hopefully get it right this time. Let's just say, you know what? I'm gonna be bold. 50,000 again. 50,000 subscribers again. I'm just 25K away. Same thing I said last year. Again, I'm gonna keep saying this every year until I get that collab. Rob Scallon, I know you're out there. I know you know who I am. You tweeted at me. I saw your guitar in Guitar Center. I was gonna buy it, but waiting to get that sponsorship. I would love to work with you. You're an idol to me. But yeah, in all seriousness, I love your work, and just keep doing what you're doing.
Rob Scallon. I definitely want to work with Rob Scallon. That guy. Oh my gosh. Now this is a big one. I didn't meet him. I didn't take a picture with him. I didn't work with him, but he noticed me. And he posted me on his Instagram. Yep.
Still and bragging about that to this day. That's a big achievement. Okay. This year, sadly, it was a year for me of like, it was a year of learning how friendships work. Like, who's really your friend and who's not and stuff like that. That's every high school experience. It's good that you get to experience it during high school and not later in life. But I have two of my best friends here with me watching the audience right now. Again, I said this last year, I'm gonna say it again. My best friends know who they are. Why did I make this a question? Yeah. No, I don't have a girlfriend. I don't. It's not even like I'm happily single right now. I'm just living my life. It's not even like I don't for a specific reason. Like I'm just, and it's not even really like I'm focusing on myself. I'm just living my life. That point hasn't came to me yet, and that's okay. Like I'm happy doing my own thing. Like really, really happy for real. And if something comes, that's great. Just living my life. I'm literally not worried about that at all. And I'm in a lot better space right now. Yeah. Ooh. This is the ultimate question. Thank you. Express your universe. I think I said this last year, I don't remember, but my motto, my phrase, my slogan that I am going to brand in the future, when I have the money to, express your universe. That saying, I am so proud to say that I came up with that saying by myself. Most people can't say that, like you came up with a catchy phrase by yourself. Express your universe, it means express your creativity, express who you are. stay true to yourself. Do what you want to do in life. Follow your dreams. And I'm such a big advocate on expression and expressing your creativity, because everyone has a gift, and everyone's gift deserves to be gifted to the universe and showed to people. Mine is, in my opinion, is creating content, whether that's music or short films or anything. That's me expressing my universe, and I'm grateful that I can have an audience for that.
One saying I live by is the saying that I created, one, and another one that I got inspiration from. One of them is, you are an expression of the universe.
Okay, so it's my
Instagram bio, and I feel like it's literally like everything in that sentence. The universe created you, God created you, but like you're from the universe, so the universe created you, whatever. You get what I mean. It's your job for you as a person to express this vast thing, the universe.
I was trying to look too much. Long story short, again, express yourself. Just express yourself. And I like how I condensed it from you are an expression of the universe, which is still my Instagram bio. I might change it to just express your universe, but yeah, it's always better to have a shorter slogan. But yeah, just express your universe. I made stickers. If you want one, DM me. Online store coming soon. Hopefully next year. No, next year I need to have my merch store. That's another thing. Next year I will have my merch store with Express Your Universe merchandise. And if anyone else steals this Express Your Universe, bro, this is my copyright right here. Like, you can't, or else I'm gonna sue you. Because I came up with it first. Because that's a good phrase, man.
That's the last question.
That's the last question?
That was the last question.
Ooh, year three done. This one felt a little shorter than the other ones, but I felt like this one was the most mature one and the one where I was the most honest with myself. And I feel like I gave good answers in terms of, like, my state as a person. Like, I feel like I'm a lot more chill, I'm a lot more just going with the flow. And yeah, but hold me accountable to everything that I said, the 50k subscribers in the merch store, because I've gained so much more knowledge on this space. Thank you guys, and I'll see you in year 4, 2024. Damn. Express your universe.
What's the hardest song you play on guitar? God damn it! Okay, bloopers.